Hi, Audra here again, and I wanted to do an enhanced life estate deed, also known as a ladybird deed, part two video. So I wanted to give you another reason as to why we don't do the enhanced life estate deeds to people. So if I put this in very practical scenario that it's easy to grasp, my mom has two daughters, myself and my sister. My mom passes away. She has an enhanced life estate deed with my sister and I listed on it. And mom dies, and now Rebecca and I, we own my mom's house equally, half to Rebecca and half to me. Sounds great. But my mom has a mortgage on the house. She has pest control, lawn control, amenities fees, taxes, utilities, all of that stuff that still needs to be paid. And I'm going to be the responsible one, and I'm gonna pay the bill. And at the end of the day, when we sell that house, I get a check for 50%, and so does my sister. Well, when we sell the house and I say, you know, hey, Rebecca, here's a receipt for all of the expenses that I have spent out of my own pocket, will you please reimburse me? My sister can say no. And there's nothing I can do about it. She owns half the house and I own half the house legally. And there's no information on that enhanced life estate deed as to how expenses are going to be paid or anything like that. And even if you have a will that says that the expenses are to be paid out of the estate, that's not going to happen because I own the house and the house is not part of the estate. My sister and I own the house equally. So that means that I would be paying the money out of my pocket or out of my inheritance, hoping and wishing that my sister would do the right thing and reimburse me at the end of the day when the house is then sold. So ladybird deeds, yes, if they actually work the way that they are intended to, you avoid probate. However, there are a lot of other complications that can happen with enhanced life estate deeds, also known as ladybird deeds. So we do caution to use enhanced life estate deeds or ladybird deeds to people because there's a lot of other known situations that can play have an effect on what happens. So if you have questions, of course, you can reach out to us, email us, or look at our YouTube channel. We have, again, a lot of other resources on there that can give you other information. But if your primary goal is to avoid the probate process with your real estate, the safest way for a lot of clients is through a revocable trust, and that's where we can help you. So feel free to contact us. We do free one-hour consultations. Bring your information into us and we'll be happy to help you. Thank you.